Get Connected. You're listening to Get Connected. Thanks for joining us. In this series, we discuss the various issues shaping your industry, how the changes in supplier ecosystems impact the way you work on a daily basis, how your customers consume the services you create, and how the industry as a whole steps up to the demands of the digital marketplace. Let's get connected.
Hello, listener. Let's get connected. My name is Chris Lewis. By day, I'm an independent industry analyst. And by night, as you may know by now, I'm a podcaster. Welcome to Get Connected, where we delve into the issues shaping the networking industry and the experiences we all benefit from by being better connected. In this episode, we're talking about the topic of network automation and how the customer experience is being impacted by the changing nature of the network and also by the changing demands on the network from the way in which we live our daily lives, live our business lives, and the way society is relying ever more heavily on connectivity. I'm delighted today to be joined by two eminent representatives from Juniper, Domenico di Mola and Cyril Doussau. Domenico, tell me about your role at Juniper.
Hello, Chris. I'm VP of Engineering in Juniper, and I'm leading the software automation development team for our service provider.
And Cyril, how about yourself?
Hi, Chris. I'm actually responsible to market our one automation and service assurance solutions and working very closely with Domenico on a day-to-day.
Thank you, both of you. And it is a topic which we see the changing demands, as we've said, on the network and the changing way in which the network needs to be built to thrive in this emerging environment. So let's get into some of the questions and see how we can build and help people's understanding of the way this is going to evolve in terms of automation and the impact on that customer experience. As the industry shifts to 5G and multi-cloud, it is becoming increasingly important for the CSPs to deliver an ever greater customer experience. What does good customer experience look like, and why, in your mind, should we measure it?
Well, Chris, one of the things that we know is that customers expect connectivity services to be transparent so that they can carry on with their day-to-day life. They demand their network to work right the first time, every time, and if it breaks, they want it to fix by itself, without to do anything. They do not want to hear about issues and expect CSPs to be proactive in addressing them. And I think this is especially important today in a world that has become quite ubiquitous and where companies need to offer appropriate connectivity to their workforce wherever they are. We actually spent the last 20 years ensuring business-critical applications are reachable from main offices. And we now need to make sure that they work well outside of the office. And unfortunately for CSP, since the beginning of the pandemic, operators do face a new challenge. Traffic patterns are changing more often, and they are also less predictable. To launch new services, they now need to find ways to measure quality properly, and they need to be able to adjust parameters of the network in order to guarantee that quality wherever the employee or their customers are located or are consuming the service from. And I think we think that that's also an opportunity for CSPs, that's an opportunity for the CSP that offer differentiated service and that focus on quality, and the one that deliver that quality through the whole life cycle of their service will be the one that will lead their market. And there are several key aspects, and key is to be able to measure that quality properly and to also be able to adjust network parameter, but at CSP scale and in real time.
And Domenico, from your perspective.
Yes, I would also say our customer, they want to use the network as a proxy. But what they're really interested in is any application and services has to work in any way anywhere, anytime. And with the COVID, post-COVID evolution, we know that we are all distributed and working in any place. So the network has to be ubiquitous. It has to be connected to the customer experience of the services. It has to be safe, healthy, and overall, it has to be easy to operate, in my opinion. And that the simplification of the operation is the ultimate experience that the customer and the customer of our customers want to have from this critical to their mission toolkit.
And I think you hit the nail on the head there, Domenico, that customer experience in this situation really represents the whole evolution of the ecosystem. And it's the customer's customer, so you and I as individuals or working in an office environment, as well as the service provider. And the pressure on the service provider is to deliver that service seamlessly so it supports all of those activities. It, as you say, it has to become invisible almost to what we're trying to achieve as individuals.
You're right. And just if I can add, it's likely you go on vacation with your family, you go with your car. The car has to be invisible to you. It has not to be part of your trip, but it has to be safe. It has to bring you where you want to go. It has to work everywhere. And moreover, if it's going to fail, you expect that your dealer is there to help you or even to call you and say your car is breaking. So you don't need to care about the car. You need to enjoy the trip with your family, the landscape, and the journey is the important part.
And that's a great analogy because, of course, that reminds me of my childhood going on holidays, you know, when my father would prepare the oil, get the maps out, do everything. So, yes, that expectation is there now that that is all part of the service delivered to you as an individual. Very good point. So on a practical level, how do you go about measuring that customer experience? You know, what tools and techniques are available to the CSP to ensure its delivery?
Oh, that's a very good question, Chris. And as of today, the network can provide a lot of probes and point of measure. We are not short in telemetry, in controlling the health of the traffic and all the kind of stuff. So we can write a book, by the way. There are a lot of books. But to me, I want to step a little bit back for our audience and for all of us to think a little bit holistically what we want to achieve, you know, before we go and test. That's really important, in my opinion. And the question I ask to myself and when I talk to my engineering team is that, what is the networking doing? You know, is our node healthy? Are all the devices working? But then I start to ask, that's not enough. What are our customers doing with the network? Shall we ask to ourselves, what are the services? What is their installation model? How do they operate the network? And when it breaks, because there is no infallible, it has to break somewhere, sometime. How do we go and intercept before it breaks? Or how do we provide a remediation that doesn't need to stop the network, but it's continuously flow without interruption? And then we mentioned it, our customer, these are the people, these are all of us working day in and day out into their critical mission, hospital, utility. How they are going to experience all these very complex machine that sits behind their day life? And that's what I keep asking to my team. And here, it's very important, an evolution and innovation that is happening is the capability to test the application by injecting synthetic traffic. To me, this is something that was always in the air, but was never coming to fruition. And now it's coming to fruition, but it has to happen in an holistic way. It's not yet another tool that is sitting in its own silos and doing its own job, but it has to be integrated into a holistic view, which if you can just let me, I can shorten in your network. You have to see, you have to know about it. You need to know what you are going to do with it. And I call the see, know, do paradigms. And with this paradigm, I always ask to my team, when we do something, we observe, we measure the network, We need to learn a pattern from what he's going to do. We need to understand the behavior, and then we need to go on what are the recommendation, what are the remediation, or in the more broader concept of autonomous network, how we're going to self-heal the network, how we're going to drive the networks in a more autonomous way, because the customer need to focus on their own job, on their own mission, and they don't need to take care, as you were saying, hey, should they change the brake? Should they change the oil? That is a job that has to stay under the cover and make sure that it is invisible to them and just freeable to them. That's my humble opinion.
And it's so true, because it's that visibility. I mean, the moving parts are so many, they've multiplied so many times. We think about IoT and the extension out to all those sensors around the world that we add into this mix. So understanding all of those information flows and building in as much automation as that is absolutely critical.
Yeah, you're right.
Now, our industry talks a lot about network transformation. What do you see as the role of automation in that? And how can an automation-led approach underpin that customer experience?
Thanks. This is a very good question. And automation is a topic that has always been with our industry. Whatever is the field you operate, we have always tried to automate because it simplifies operations that are done manually, it scales, and it provides overall a human-less type of operation, which increases the efficiency. But again, I want still to step back and look at a little bit broadly the concept of automation. And to me, when I think about automation, it comes to my mind a sentence of Bill Gates that say, applying automation to an efficient organization or an efficient operation, it will just increase the inefficiency. You have to build automation from the foundation. It's a bottom-up approach. And the concept of transformation that you are mentioning is exactly that. The service provider cannot attach automation as a sort of a post-it or as a sort of a patch. It has to be built into the foundation. It has to be built into the way they operate, into the way they design the network, but in the way also their organization are set up. But going a little bit further, to me, automation is a piece of the concept of automatic network, which is a piece of the broader concept of a self-driving network or autonomous network. And you need to look at this objective at your horizon when you think about automation. And the keyword of all these paradigm is closed loop. Automation without a closed loop is just another toolkit. And the closed loop, it's effectively how we are going to improve the customer experience, how we are going to enhance that experience to the point where the customer can have on their iPad or on their screen, not all the different knobs, but how effectively their service are operating. Are their KPI aligned with the business mission? Is the SLA working correctly? Is their network going to break? And when it's going to break, what are the different steps that their operation team has to do? And then it can give feedback to the planning and design team that effectively can understand where the network is having efficiency while the customer and the customer of the customer are operating in real life. So this is the complex picture that we needed to understand. And I want to say complex, to not say complicated, because the complexity can be solved by the automation and the closed loop into this network transformation, in my humble opinion.
And Cyril?
Yes, definitely. I completely agree. Without automation, you cannot guarantee the service experience. And especially as CSPs are adopting the principle of cloud networks and leveraging cloud native application. And so there is actually many things that CSPs can use to improve the customer journey. It can be used to help them automatically discover the service that they need to purchase. You talk about the principle of NAS, how they can acquire it, how they can purchase it, how they will use the service, and how it will be guaranteed, so how we will deliver the SLAs. And still, I think when we talk with CSPs, we often hear that there are many different steps that could have been automated and are not yet automated. So we often hear, for example, that we yet are to implement quality check prior to onboard customer or after a network upgrade. This could be automated. We could as well automate a lot of time-consuming processes. So when you have to upgrade your network OS, for example, and you have many different equipment, all those processes can be automated. So I think most CSP would agree that today, if you're not planning to automate your network, you're on the wrong path. And what's exciting about it is that there's, while we need to have the foundation, as you discussed, Domenico, there's also a lot of different simple processes that where we can start and provide real value to operation and as well the customer.
So Cyril, you touch upon the issue really that springs to my mind here, which is that, you know, transforming a network can be a very long-term project to really leverage all of these issues. But what are CSPs able to do in the short term, those initial steps you just talked about, to really get the thing moving?
Yes, and I can give you a few examples of things that they can do. So for one of our customers, we help them to automatically configure and deploy radio access cell site and activate a site in 2 hours. While it used to take them 1 day to do it manually. And at the end of the day, they were not able to plan the launch of their service on time. But thanks to automation, they can lower the time it takes to provision the service and therefore meet their target. And I'm thinking of another example where we were able to help a tier one to automatically test quality prior to onboard a customer. So it used to be that they had what we called failed delivery, by which the service was working, but they didn't really test it because it takes time, it's complex, you need to send engineers sometimes on sites. And now that's a process that we've automated for them. And now when they onboard a customer, they can be sure that quality is there end-to-end, and they don't have those failed service delivery rates. So it's really helpful because it prevents them to have all those escalation with the customer and confirm the SLAs that have been sold.
I think what you raised there is really interesting, because the nature of an enterprise network, the way these were built in the past along very rigid lines, you know, MPLS, private circuits, all these sort of things, as we move into the SD-WAN environment, where it's defined by the software, and therefore the complexity of that is even greater. So to be able to onboard a customer having pre-tested that configuration is extremely valuable, because you don't want those problems to occur, you know, once it's been put in place. So yeah, that's a very good point.
Maybe one last example that I can share here, Chris, is the ability to, as you say, we need to make sure that all the different equipment that support the end-to-end service delivery chain are working. That's also something that we are doing for another tier one. And we have the ability to, we are letting them reconfigure their network if we can see that one of the paths that they're using might impact the quality. And so that's also something like automating the traffic engineering is something that will bring a lot of value to CSPs.
And if I can just add a few words, well said, Cyril. I think it's really straight to the point. Is that as you know, Juniper is a master in networking and in network automation. We have always built around this concept. But to your point, how we can make our customer doing this transition, and how we are helping them at the end. These are our customers. There are several ways that we are doing and trying to nail down this problem. And one is making sure that when we build this layer of on top of the automation, and we haven't spent enough time also to talk about another add-on that is coming, that is AI machine learning, that will be introduced together with the automation to even further simplify. But going back to the original, we are trying to make sure that when we deliver our automation suite and capability, we always look at both aspects of the problem. How to simplify the network and make sure that the customer doesn't need to go and touch everything, but also we understand that they do need to have some visibility on some of the key component, because that's how they are going to operate, and we cannot just deliver a black box. So our system are built to make sure that the customer can use and consume our software for automation via the traditional CLI, or in a more advanced way via API or via GUI interface. So we give it to customer that level of flexibility, where this simplification, it comes in a way that they can consume in a different stages and in a different stages of their journey toward this transformation. Because we have to understand that the journey is going to be as important or even more important than the endpoint, because that endpoint will be a moving target. We started, we don't know where we are going finally to end, but the journey is very important because that's where the network will evolve. And so, to closing this last remark, I fundamentally believe that the cooperation and co-creation with the customer, looking at the hardware, but also looking to their process, workflow, action, and also looking how their organization skills and how they are operating is transforming, and bringing back in our software for automation that experience of themselves in our software for automation is the best way to help them into this journey.
I think, you know, there's so many moving parts as we discuss the industry and as we analysts try and analyze the industry. You know, we used to take pieces down to a microscopic level and analyze them. I think we're beginning to see now, to your point, Domenico, rolling up many of these issues into discrete parcels that we automate, closed loop automation that we bring together, we use AI to wrap it all together. But tell me and tell the listener a bit more about the Juniper automation portfolio.
Cyril, you want to take a first stab and then I'll add my engineering heart to your comment?
Yes.
Thanks.
So to that extent, we launched this year Paragon Automation. And Paragon Automation is a modular portfolio of cloud-native software application that deliver that closed-loop automation that Domenico was talking about it. And what's really important is it's actually a modular suite of automation solutions that the operators can use through the entire network and service lifecycle. So, for example, they can plan, model, verify service quality before deploying, orchestrate end-to-end services, actively verify service quality across physical and virtual networks. They can correlate network health by leveraging machine learning to offer predictive analysis and granular analysis, and they can simplify that path optimization and slice creation. We didn't talk too much about network slicing, but that's a very important concept that is coming, and we're going to have to deliver that end-to-end slice, and it's going to be possible to support the quality of that end-to-end slice only if we're able to automate and, once again, fine-tune the characteristic of that slice on the fly. So that solution of that suite of application is actually offered as a cloud-hosted or as a SaaS solution. And you can host it in a private cloud or in a public cloud. It's a composed of a microservice-based architecture that allow you to horizontally scale and quickly leverage the services that you deliver in your network. But I think Domenico can talk a bit more about it. He's the one with his team who's engineering that solution.
Yeah, right. And in this last few, let my engineering heart pulse and say that I'm so proud of our team and the passion they're putting to really solve this problem for the customer and the customer of our customer. And indeed, the way we are architecting our solution is that the simplification has to come on top of the complexity and the remaining moving part. So we're trying to break the problem in a little problem, because the ask I made and I made it to myself is, whatever you're building, it has to be scalable, it has to be elastic, and it has to be programmable, because effectively we have a view, but we don't know everything, and these many moving parts will continue to evolve, technology will change. So scalability, elasticity, and programmability have to be the foundation of the product that you're building. And we have done a cloud-native product, so it can be deployed on a prem, it can be deployed on a SaaS, on a cloud, in a hybrid model. So to make sure that, again, our customer does have the toolkit to solve their problem at simplified way. And then the other two dimensions that I want to comment, because I'm really proud of the work we have done, and our customers are giving us a very positive feedback, is that, as Cyril was saying, we have adopted a microservices architecture, heavily founded on API. But the very important part at customer visibility level is that we have a certain number of applications that Cyril has just spoken, but we're also building a workflow, the capability to connect all these dots in order that the customer can consume an app at different level of complexity into their workflow, or they can use a very simplified workflow and use all the app in a row. And so if you go into these metrics with the third dimension, that is our cloud native microservices architecture, you have a sort of cube in front of our customer where we can work really closely to our customer to simplify their job through our automation and closed loop capability, rather than giving them a black box, and then they need to scratch their head and say, yeah, this is yet another problem, and this will cost money, and they just walk away from this concept. And in the past, I've seen many times this happening, and I believe that with respect to the market landscape we are operating, where there are a lot of players, we have done a really good job in simplifying this concept, exposing this concept to our customer, and make sure that the customer can decide with us what is the best suite of automation for them. And I believe that is a differentiator we're putting in the marketplace coming to this topic.
And it occurs to me, as you both were speaking there, that this is indicative of the changing nature of the CSP, the changing role the CSP has in the broader ecosystem, and how they're all quite different. So the fact that you can customize that around individual telcos' requirements is unbelievably important, because their skill level, their knowledge level of different technologies is going to be very, very varied. So being able to deliver it in the different formats becomes absolutely critical. So to bring all of this together for the listener, where would you say we are on this customer experience journey?
So reducing network complexity with automation is a journey, as you're saying. The good news is that CSPs can improve easily. And we see that because we know that they are not yet equipped with the right solution. If they had the right solution, they would be able to automate some of their processes. And I would suggest that basically they start with processes such as zero-touch provisioning, automated service quality testing, automated traffic engineering, or automated peering engineering, which are basically some use case where CSPs can get an immediate benefits. And we can see with many CSPs that those automation are not yet in place.
And if I can just very shortly add, my experience is that our customers are taking a very layered approach to the problem, because they have anyhow to run the network and make it working. So they're trying to solve through the automation the first and most simple problems, typically coming from organization and from planning. And so, for example, reducing the time to root cause analysis of a troubleshoot and reducing the number of tickets, that is already an important achievement for their organization and operation. So again, a layered approach and simple problem, and build on top your experience, your transformation, skills, and then the evolution of this software that has to solve the automation problem, in my opinion.
Cyril and Domenico, thank you so much for joining me today on Get Connected.
Thanks for having me. Really appreciate it.
Yes, thank you very much.
So, there you have it, listener. The good news is there are plenty of quick wins. It changes the relationship between the supplier and the CSP, which ultimately underpins that long-term customer experience that gets delivered to all of us in our business or our consumer lives. I think it's also, all the way through this discussion, it's very evident that your relationship with your customers is changing, in the same way that the relationship with the CSP with their customers is changing in this broader digital environment. So I think the acknowledgement of all of our weaknesses becomes very important in the way we go to market, the way we work with our customers. I think the automation of all of these different elements, we could do it all at once, but it would be an enormous challenge and will probably be an enormous mess. So a much more layered approach, as you said, is absolutely the right way to do it. Now, all that remains is a few thank yous. Thank you to Juniper for enabling us to bring out this discussion, how the automation of all of the activities underlying the delivery of the customer experience can be brought together, turning that toolkit of technology into the engine that drives us forward as an industry. And thank you to you too for listening. I look forward to talking to you again soon.
You've been listening to Get Connected. You've heard from us, now we'd love to hear from you. Tell us what you think via Twitter using the handle @JuniperNetworks. And if you like what you've heard, remember to tell your colleagues and friends. Thanks for listening to Get Connected.